Assalamu alaikum everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Finding Him. You know, the first two episodes, I was just explaining and, you know, introducing myself. But it's in this episode that I actually get to do what this whole series is about, is sharing my, you know, the things that I learned and my experiences with you in becoming a new Muslim and what happens afterwards. Now, on the first day after I took my shahada, it was kind of a blur, but very happy, you know. I took the shahada not really knowing how to do it. So someone actually had to teach me. And that's actually part of what I'm going to tell you today. Last episode, actually, at the end, I told you that I'm going to tell you what I did on the first day. But looking back, I think I should share with you exactly how to officially become a Muslim first. So the big question is, how do you become a Muslim? Okay, basically, you do this thing that's called the shahada, which is basically the declaration of faith. You know, so what I was taught is that you raise your index finger of the right hand, and then you say a few words in Arabic. And then when I did it, I was asked to do it in English as well right after, just so that I understand what I'm saying. And actually, that's much better, right? Because when you're saying just a whole bunch of words that you don't know, you can't really feel it. So you want to, when you're making this huge decision, you want to feel it. So I'm just going to share some of my notes. Trusty notes. So I have these notes with me that just so not only I want to get all the points across, but it's a good refresher for myself as well to look at them. So let's go to shahada. Okay. So like I said, when you want to become officially a Muslim, you declare this thing. It's called the shahada, the testimony of faith. And it's a few Arabic words, and I'm going to say them for you. And since I'm nervous, I'm going to read them, okay? Because I don't want to mess it up. Okay, so it goes like this. This is the shortest one, the simplest one. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Okay, and so those words actually mean, I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship aside from Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his messenger. Okay, so that is basically how you become a Muslim. You just say those words in Arabic and automatically you're a Muslim. Okay, so on that day, I actually just said the shahada in the way that someone told me. I didn't really really understand the significance of it. It was just like, okay, Lisa, put up your finger and say these words. But I really think that it's important to understand what the conditions of the shahada is. So if I could just share with you about that in this episode, okay? Now, the conditions of the shahada, there's basically eight, but I call them 7+1 because there's seven that kind of build upon one another, and then the last one is something that you do at the climax. So the first one is knowledge. Why knowledge? It's because you need to know that you have to put up your finger. You have to know how to say the Arabic words. It's good to know that you have to put up your finger, you have to say it in Arabic and what those words mean. So that's the knowledge, okay? Number two is certainty. You have to really believe in the shahada. So that means you have to believe that there is Allah. Allah is there, He's the creator of the world, and that Prophet Muhammad is His messenger. So you have to be certain about that. Next one, acceptance. You have to accept the words of the shahada and not reject them. You have to accept that they're true, basically. Fourth one, submission. Now we know that the word Muslim means someone who submits, but what does that really mean? It means submitting not only your life, but you're submitting to basically the laws of Allah. Now you've basically accepted Allah into your life as your Lord and your creator. You have to also basically accept His rules, His house rules. So that's what submission means. Number five is truthfulness. Someone who says the shahada, actually anyone could just say the words of the shahada, right? But a person who is becoming a new Muslim, they need to make sure that they're saying the shahada with truthfulness. And what does that mean? You say the shahada from your heart. It's not just lip service. It's something that you really feel. So that is truthfulness. Next is sincerity or excellence. Now, someone who says the shahada with sincerity means not only do they understand the words and meanings, they are certain about it, they accept it, They feel it in their hearts, but also they have this sincerity in really wanting to improve themselves, change their life, and they really believe that, you know, Islam is the way, Allah is the one, and the person to idolize is Prophet Muhammad. So this is the excellence and the sincerity that a new Muslim, and actually every Muslim, has to show. Number seven is like the ultimate, you know, feeling of love. This love that you have for Allah because you know that He created you, you've finally found the truth, and that Prophet Muhammad was sent by Allah to show you exactly how to live your life in the best possible way. Because Islam really is something that comes to your life. Once you become a new Muslim, you will realize, you know, over time, little by little, that the rulings and the commands and the way that the Muslims actually live their life is something that is healthy, pure, something that gives you real calm and peace, not only in your head, but also in your heart. So this is a love that you have for Allah, you have for His Messenger. The next condition, is that you have to have a certain type of disbelief. And what is that disbelief? Is that once you love Allah so much, you love Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you love your brothers and sisters in faith, you also have to disbelieve anything that, you know, you have to disbelieve and not worship anything that is not Allah, basically. You have to abandon everything else. So that's the 7 plus 1 of the conditions of the Shahada. Aside from saying the Shahada, there's other things that you should be doing on the first day. For example, on the very first day after you take your Shahada, it's highly recommended that you take a religious bath. And this bath, it actually is symbolizing, you know, washing away your past life and your past sins. So it's really highly recommended that you take it. But what it's all about, what it's called, how do you do it? Actually, that's going to be in our next episode. So stay tuned for the next episode when I teach you how to basically just be pure and clean for the religion. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Now, if you just tuned in to this episode and you're like, who is this girl? I have no idea who she is. She just talks really fast and a lot. Well, you can learn more about me in the previous episodes. Also, you can get all these videos at the DOPS channel, which is here. Please subscribe if you can. No, not if you can. You must subscribe, please. And of course, if you liked this video, please do like and also share. And you can also comment, or you can go to my Facebook and have, you know, a little chat with me at Facebook.com/officialalizakim. And again, the next episode, I'm going to be talking about ablution. Exactly what is that anyway? You know, how to do it, why you do it, and why it prepares you to do everything else in life. Okay, so tune in.